Don't think I don't love you guys because we didn't have coffee yesterday. We did. It's just the vlog was so long it had to be edited out. So I had coffee without you. Now I did take a few souvenirs with me last night when I came back from the Manson Ranch. Remember that old electric pole that was burned down? It's the only thing left out there that was on the property when the Manson family lived there? Yeah, I hacked a few pieces off of it for some friends. And just because I love history, I like stupid stuff like that, so don't judge me for being weird. And we can't start the day without that beautiful face poking out of the bedding. Good morning, Joster. How are you today, fella? I think the fans love seeing that face every day just as much as I do. Yeah, that's right, buddy. You have fans now, Jaw. There he comes. Look, there's Bela Lugosi's house. I decided when we were driving back from the dog park. Shoot, since I now know about the staircase that takes you to Bela Lugosi's house, maybe I should just pull over and we should get some exercise. So, John and I are gonna go walk the staircase. And there it is. I don't know how many times we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it at least once or twice. But I'm not gonna leave you guys to do this with us. We'll catch up with you afterward. Here we are, Bella's house. Oh, look, they even decorated it. Put some Halloween decorations up. How do they not have something of him? Put Dracula, put something. That's pretty cool. Like a little pug. We're gonna work our way back down. And down we go. Same rule applies. We won't force you to go down the whole way with us. But go ahead, buddy. Come on. See, he walks way far ahead of me. Then as soon as I got let go of the leash so he can go do it and get a little bit of space, he stops so I can trip over the leash. What a friend. Once you're out of the habit of exercising every day and you're somebody who normally does or did, it's so hard to get back into it. This is my start though. I feel like, you know, I tend to just wear myself out on workouts where I'll go and do the same one for like every day for 2 months. And then I can't stand to go up there anymore. But now that I know about this, stairs is really good exercise. So I figure I'll stop and do a couple of rounds of these stairs. And look at that, we're down at the bottom. And back up we go. I mean, I feel like they should just name these the Bela Lugosi steps. Whether he used them or not, I mean, they definitely would have been around in his day because the stonework across the street is exactly like that. I think they should just memorialize these as Bela stairs. I'm going to anyway. Down we go again. Oh, by the way, I got another Patreon. We got another person donating to the cause for Patreon. Thank you so much, Vernwood. Really appreciate that. He's doing the opposite of what I thought he would do. Instead of running ahead of me, he's waiting like 20 stairs behind me, waits till I get somewhere, then all of a sudden he just darts down the stairs. Knucklehead. That's my boy though. My friend. My legs are feeling this. We're gonna do it a third time. He's coughing or scoffing, which probably means he doesn't want to do it much more. So we're gonna do it three times up and down and call it a day. This is kind of cool. This is a little back staircase that goes up into Bella's place, his property. He very well could have used this You know what's crazy about Bella is, if you look up pictures of him when he's not acting, he's a pretty snappy dresser. And he always kind of hated being known as a universal monster because he saw himself as a leading man. Thought the rest of them were just ugly ghouls. Yeah, three times I think will be enough. There's the house again. He doesn't want to come down. He's tired of it. My legs are sore. Come on, bud. Last one down. I hear him. He's coming. Here he is. Sweating all the way through my shirt after just a few rounds of this. Whoo! This is the best case scenario. Where I usually take Jaw to hike in Griffith Park. It's so ungodly hot out there right now. If we don't leave the house by like 7 a.m., we just can't do it because he overheats and he'll just lay down and quit moving. And there's no shade up there, so it's just all heat. So since I take him to the park anyway, this is probably a really good situation for now that I can hit these stairs. Well, today's vlog is a pretty cool one for me because when I was 15, over one summer, I watched La Bamba. It was on HBO constantly, just about every day, sometimes twice a day. I watched that movie so much that I just absolutely fell in love with it. And that's what made me learn guitar. I went and bought a white guitar just like Ritchie Valens had. And I started learning how to play Ritchie Valens songs. And if you've ever seen the movie or if you know the story of Ritchie Valens, when he first finally started making some money, he bought his mom a house, and this is the house that he bought her before he died. He was able to move her in just very shortly before he died, and wow, family hasn't lived here for a while, but this was it. They lived here for a very, very, very long time. We're gonna also go over to Ritchie Valens' grave. Ritchie sang La Bamba, Come On Let's Go, Donna, and he was really the very first Latin rock and roll superstar. God, what a great movie. If you've never seen La Bamba, go see it. There's a part where, you know, pretty much is pretty accurate that Ritchie and Bob got into a fight because Ritchie was able to buy her this house, and this is it. Mother Connie's house. Well, this is what Pacoima looks like. Never come to Pacoima. Oh, there's a Long John Silver's. Oh, man. I never thought I'd be so excited. This was one of my favorite places to go when I was a little kid in Ohio. You just can't find these anymore. We may have to pull through there. I decided to pull in Long John Silver after all.
The hush puppies are gone, man.
You know, Pacoima really looks a lot like everywhere else. We're heading to the cemetery now. Gonna go visit, it's actually a shared tombstone between Ritchie and his mother. Look at that, Ritchie Valens Recreation Center. Wasn't even looking for that. We just stopped at a light, I looked over, and there it is. Perfect for the Ritchie Valens vlog. Ritchie Valens Pool. Wow, I didn't know that Ritchie Valens had a recreation center named after him or a pool. As we're getting on the freeway, there it was. Pacoima loved Ritchie Valens, that's for sure. And of course, as a 15-year-old boy watching La Bamba, this was the heartbreaking scene when the hearse pulls into this entrance right here into the San Fernando Mission Cemetery to lay Ritchie to rest. You know, it's crazy about me seeing that movie. It was things like that that when I would see it, I'd go, well, that just tells me I need to move to California and I need to do something with my life, that I need to live and not worry about, you know, what the future holds as much as like enjoying life now and getting the most out of it, seeing the things that I want to see in the world and enjoying the things that I'm interested in. And so when I moved here, yeah, within the first couple of months I came here, I had to. I wanted to see Richie, and I was in music school at the time, going to Musicians Institute, and it just inspired me to work so much harder. Well, I'm here at the San Fernando Mission Cemetery, and I'm pretty positive that Richie Valens is over here in this section. I've been here one time before, and pretty interesting story about it. Let's see where he would be. There's actually a picture of him on there. There he is. Okay. So here's the interesting story, is that when I came here, the one other time that I've been here, there was a woman here with her daughter. And I came walking up and they were standing here. We didn't really say much to each other for a while, and I just sat here and kept staring, because like I said, Richie Valens is a big deal to me. I mean, he's the reason that I learned how to play music. From seeing La Bamba, that I actually would go, before you could go online, I would get record ordering books, and I would track down record stores all over the country, and I'd call the 1-800 numbers, and I would find people that still had his records. So I actually have the two records they released by him on vinyl. I have original copies because I tracked them down as like a 15-year-old. And when I came out here, there was a woman and her daughter. I'd say the woman was probably at the time 65, something like that. And I was standing here just admiring it, and the woman walks over to me and she said, "Are you a fan of his?" And I said, "Yeah." And her daughter was about my age, said, "Oh, this is my mother. My mother went to school with Richie." And I said, "Really? What was he like?" And she said, "He was a really sweet boy, but you know what?" She said, "He was not in class very often. And then when his songs came out on the radio, I think I saw him one or two times in school after that, and then you never saw him again." She said he was an extremely sweet boy and extremely nice, and here it is, Richie Valens' grave. Now, if you go and read online, you'll find out that, Brother Bob from the movie, and from Rich, you know, obviously Richie's brother, he's still alive. They don't live in this town anymore, but he's a biker and he's still around, man. He's a rebel with a mohawk and everything. Richie, if you don't know the story, of course, it was memorialized in Don McLean's Famous American Pie. But Richie Valens, the Big Bopper, and Buddy Holly all hopped on a plane, middle of a snowstorm, and they died in the wreckage. And it was pretty sad, you know. Look at Richie's birthday. Look at that. Teenager. And this is his mother, Connie, whose house we went to today that Richie bought her. Look at the sky. And that's something. It's like a big X marks the spot right there. I'm really glad I was able to make it out here finally for this. I mean, I know there had to be other people from my generation that were inspired by La Bamba and really, like, the whole rock and roll movement owes a lot to Richie Valens. I mean, that's Those songs were songs that people have been singing for 60 years now. People that don't even know what La Bamba means, they don't even know what those lyrics are, can sing the song. Isn't that incredible? Now also, since we're here, William Frawley, Fred Mertz, from I Love Lucy, he's buried here. So I figure let's walk over and find him. Take a look while we're here. Look at the knotting on that tree, isn't that something? It almost looks like somebody carved people into it. Sacred Heart of Jesus statue. There's old William Frawley, Fred Mertz. Now, if you remember, go way back into my early archives of Days with Jordan the Lion, the Knickerbocker Hotel. William Frawley had a heart attack on the front steps of the Knickerbocker Hotel. They helped him, escorted him into the lobby, and he passed away in the lobby. Loving memory of William C. Frawley. Also known as Bub from My Three Sons. I thought I'd share the two albums that I have. This was the record that they released of Richie's. Mine's kind of like a rough copy. You can tell it was obviously used before. But this was the record that would have been out when Richie was alive. And this was something that they put out after Richie died. Now, Bob Keane, do you guys, if you've seen La Bamba, you know who Bob Keane is. Bob's the guy who discovered Richie, and it was his manager, and, you know, when I watched La Bamba, one of those things that I was always, like, wondering to myself is Bob Keane around, and is there any way to meet Bob Keane? You know, I lived here, I moved to Los Angeles in 2000, and, when I lost one of my jobs, I used to go hiking up Griffith Park every day, and a girl there helped get me a job at Jerry's Famous Deli. She got me a delivery job because since I was in a band and needed to be able to perform at night, I got a job there where I got off at 3 p.m. And one day they sent me on a delivery across the street. I worked at the Beverly Hills Jerry's Deli that's no longer there. They sent me across the street to some office buildings, some doctor's offices, right beside Cedars-Sinai. And as I'm waiting at the nurse's reception desk to get paid for their order, a man walks up in sunglasses, slams his hands down on the counter, and looks at the ladies and says, "I'm Robert Keane. I'm here to see the doctor." And I did about a 3-second thought and then a double take, and I looked over and I said, "Bob Keane is in Delphi Records, Bob Keane?" And he goes, "Yep, that's me." I go, "Oh my God, sir, I'm a huge Richie Valens fan from seeing La Bamba," and I just, you know, told him what a big fan I was and everything and what a pleasure it was to meet him, and I said, "I have a million questions for you," and he said, "Well, buy my book, I tell everything in my book, and I live over on," I think he said Orange Grove at the time, I remember it was looking it up and it was by Fairfax and Fountain, he said, "I live over there, if you have any questions, come talk to me." And I just never did. I got the book, read it, it was awesome, but I never went and talked to him, and he passed away a few years ago. But that was my happenstance of meeting Robert Keane, Bob Keane, Richie's manager. I started drinking these every day. Not the whole thing. This is like the big jug. But I drink about half of it a day, sometimes more, just depends. Just a good way of getting back into doing the green juices and getting the greens every day. Current mood. What a great looking sky. Beautiful sky. Bud, are you hungry? Let's go get you some food. Come on. Vlog over.